Welcome to an absolutely glorious afternoon here in East Lothian. We're here at Tantallon Castle. Now, this is a very special type of castle. It's known as a curtain wall castle. It overlooks the sea, and my goodness, the views are absolutely incredible. Let's go and take a look round. Visitors haven't been able to go inside Tantallon Castle for a number of years because they've been renovating and repairing some of the walls, which have become dangerous. So I'm really pleased to be able to get back into this spectacular castle today. You can just see the sea over there. And of course, the sea plays a major role in this type of castle's defences. We'll start here by the outer wall. And I guess down there, that's the moat. And then we're going to go across the bridge and through the great outer gate. And our first views of Tantallon Castle ruins. Oh my goodness, look at this. As you can see, we're right on the clifftop here. Absolutely gorgeous coastline, isn't it? And if we turn and look at the castle itself, it starts to become clear why this particular spot was of such strategic significance. Maybe that wasn't the moat before. Looks like there's another moat there, with a bridge, of course, going over it. Before we go inside the castle, there's just one more coastal view that we really need to indulge in. Just look at what emerges from behind the wall. There we go. Bass Rock. A few weeks ago, Mrs. E and I did a vlog of a boat trip we took around Bass Rock. Remember all those hundreds of thousands and gannets and puffins? On the way back from the boat trip, they sailed along the coastline here for a really good look at Tantallon Castle from on the sea. Actually, that's what inspired me to come back here today. And here we can see how the castle is absolutely perched right on the cliff edge. And that's what's unique about these curtain wall castles. Now, a normal castle will have four walls and a moat all the way around it. This one effectively only has the one wall, the curtain wall. The other three edges of the castle are all sheer cliff. So easy to defend because most of it is actually cliff going all the way down into the water. Right then, let's get inside that castle. I think we're going to get a serious dose of the power of history any minute now. Through the castle walls and into the protected enclave. Wow. Castle walls and Bass Rock there in the background. That's stunning, isn't it? I'm gonna say it. Feel the power of history. I think these windows will really reinforce how precariously perched on the cliff this place is. Yeah, look at that. Fabulous view across the Firth of Forth. And here's why we don't need the other three walls. The cliffs themselves are the other three walls. It's a bloody long way down there. But to get our best feel for how the castle works, we're gonna have to get up on those battlements. Spooky staircase. Of course, in the 13th century, they wouldn't have had these electric lights, would they? Torch lights, I guess, would have been the order of the day. Oh, there's always spiral staircases, isn't there? Halfway to the top. Our final destination is up there. I think there's something really therapeutic about exploring ruined castles, don't you? Up the last spiral staircase we go. Actually, this one's not as precarious as the other one. Incredible, incredible views across the coast. What a beautiful day it is today as well. Oh, it's a long way down there. Well, now we're at the top, I can show you the unique defensive capabilities of this location. So there you can see how the wall effectively segments this cliff edge from the rest of the land and makes it pretty much impregnable. The cliffs on three sides and the curtain wall on the fourth side. If you think about it, there's no way, even with the biggest and most heavily armed of ships, that they would have been able to have attacked from the sea. So the only option would have been to attack from the land, and then they come up against those incredible strong walls. More incredible views of Bass Rock there, with all its hundreds and thousands of seabirds, and beyond, if you can just look a bit further, that's the Isle of May. Actually, it's unusual to be able to see that so clearly. Like I said before, the castle's been closed for a couple of years whilst they carry out repairs on some of the walls which have become dangerous. Now, some of the walls, like this one, are still being renovated, so we can't explore all of the castle. As a result, they've reduced the price. Only cost me £3.80 to visit today. What an incredible place this is. Do you know, I could sit here looking out to sea, looking out towards Bass Rock from here at Tantallon Castle with a great big black coffee in hand and a good book, and I'd be really happy for the whole afternoon. So there you have it, Tantallon Castle. Well worth a visit if you're in East Lothian. 5 miles south of North Berwick, £3.80 to get in. Now you can't complain about that for value for money, can you? Thank you so much for watching this episode of Rog Vlog. If you enjoyed the video, please do subscribe to the YouTube channel. Until the next one, remember, there's always something to see, so get out there and find it. Every time your dream's been put on hold, the story learn, but you still get burned, but you still get burned.